tested me. What the f*** going on?
Let's begin today's episode with actually talking about the breaking news that sort of came out of the Ferrari camp. So we're going to put this article up here so that everybody at home can see it as well. So this is sort of similar to a story that broke last season as well. And this is actually McLaren. So McLaren are very unhappy with a move that Ferrari made with Laurent Mekies. So if you guys are not sure who Laurent Mekies is, that's okay. I didn't know who he was either until this article came out. Laurent Mekies is the FIA's deputy race director and head of safety. So the big news was that he was heading to Maranello in September. So he was going to join the Scuderia and be part of the Ferrari team. Mekies is the second high-profile FIA official to join a team over the past year. So you guys, this is what I was talking about. Last year, it was with Martin Budkowski. He moved to Renault, and he was also with the FIA. So there was this big, big issue and controversy of, you know, FIA personnel and employees moving to F1 teams. So basically, the biggest issue is here is that when you work for the FIA, you obviously have access to a lot of information. You know, a lot of the safety regulations, racing regulations, et cetera, et cetera. You have a lot of information that you bring with you. So the issue that teams brought up last year with Renault and now this year with Ferrari is that it's going to provide a competitive edge for Ferrari bringing on a person like Mekies. Because like I mentioned before, he was the FIA's deputy race director and head of safety. So he's got a lot of valuable information that I think Ferrari and any other team could use. So this was the big controversy last year too of, you know, they wanted to sort of let these employees from the FIA, if they did decide to leave, that they would be put on garden leave, which I think is a term mostly used in the UK. I haven't heard that used here in Canada, but they had agreed upon that no FIA employee or official would join an F1 team for a period of 12 months. And as we scroll down in this article, we can see that Laurent Mekies will be leaving the FIA in June and joining in September. So obviously, he's definitely not within that grace period. And McLaren were very unhappy that they, were losing another key employee to a racing team, the FIA. This was coming from Eric Boullier, and Zach Brown came out and said that he was agreed with the comments. So they had agreed in a strategy group meeting a while back that no key technical FIA employees would be employed by a race team within 12 months. And then obviously they went against it. So this is where the news comes in that they had agreed in air quotes, a gentleman's agreement that no FIA personnel would join a team within 12 months. And then obviously Ferrari said they agreed at the time and said, okay, you know, that's cool. And then, you know, they just went ahead and hired the guy anyway. So this is where the big question comes is Formula One sort of a sport where you have something like a gentleman's agreement, or, you know, is it just so competitive that everybody's looking for an edge? Everybody's trying to get ahead, you know, a couple of tenths of seconds here, you know, a couple thousands of pounds or dollars here or there just to make your team better. So, you know, it's interesting. I want to pull this tweet up from Martin Brundle, who said this in reaction. So I'll read this tweet to everybody who's just listening. Martin Brundle says, "There are no gentlemen in F1. Never have been. That's what makes it so raw and engaging, and why I dislike the current." this is the part that really gets me. This is why I dislike the current snowflake attitude of some towards F1. It's about delivery and excellence. Win or lose, dog eat dog. Deliver or move over. Fastest, fearless, gifted, and great. 240 characters on Twitter has come in pretty handy for debates and statements like this. And I just love that comment from Brundle, the snowflake attitude. I think that's been going around quite a lot these days. So, you know, the fact that an old school driver, not just in sport, but everywhere else. So it's funny to see sort of a former driver come out and say that comment. I quite enjoyed that. And you know what? There's a big part of me that agrees with a lot that he says. And, you know, for those that don't know, Martin Brundle was a former driver. He drove, an excellent, actually, a GP2 season back with Ayrton Senna. They had a really good rivalry that went on there. But he's a former driver and obviously commentator for Sky Sports now. Really, really knowledgeable guy. And he would know better than anybody, you know, the competitive world of Formula One and what it's like to compete at a highest level. I mean, there's one thing about being a professional basketball player or hockey player, but there's another level in terms of being a professional Formula One driver. There's so much on the line, especially for a team like Ferrari, who, you know, came off a really disappointing 2017 season. I mean, they had the championship sort of within their hands throughout the first 6 months of the year, and then completely just lost it at the end with reliability, with obviously the collision in Singapore. So they're really looking to bounce back this year, and there's a lot of pressure on the boys at Maranello to perform. You know, a lot of pressure on Kimi and Sebastian as well to get that Ferrari back where it belongs, and that's, you know, world champion, constructors champion. So I think that what Martin Brundle's trying to say is that there's really no room for this, you know, gentleman's agreement and being soft and being nice. If you want to win, you have to really, really kind of not necessarily cut corners sometimes, but you're going to have to do some things that people aren't going to like. And this is exactly what Ferrari has done. So, you know, let us know in the comments. Send us some tweets of what you guys think about this. You know, did Ferrari do the right thing? I mean, because one of the biggest things that I was interested in is whether this agreement, this gentleman's agreement, was written down, you know, legally anywhere. So was this a contract that they signed, or was just, you know, just an agreement amongst, you know, these teams in a boardroom? Because if that's the case, then Ferrari didn't really do anything legally incorrect. But if they had signed something, if something's in some sort of a contract, then obviously that's a different story. But I think Martin Brundle, you know, he kind of summed it up fast. And, you know, that's the reality of the sport. If you're not willing to get sort of down and dirty almost, you know, if you want to use that word that way, then like he said, you know, deliver or move over.